Fanny, it's on a boost. Still on a ride, just like my coupe. She wanna get high, changing the mood. She wanna get fly, feel like a broom. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Thank you all so much for clicking on my video. So let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, so for starters, this video was requested by Queen T. She left a comment under my video basically asking about TSU in general, because she plans to come to TSU, and so she wants to feel like she will have a good experience at TSU. And she also wanted to know or wanted me to explain my, or talk about my experience at TSU. So that's what this video is going to consist of. So for one, and we all know that TSU is a HBCU. So with that being said, like, y'all know black people don't never do right. We can't never do right. So I want to say this, and like, this is what I tell everybody. Like, you're going to have, I don't want to say issues, but you're going to deal with obstacles at TSU. There's going to be something every semester that you're going to have to deal with, whether that's financial aid or your housing or both. Anything. TSU is always, let me take this off. TSU, it's just always something going on. I don't even want to blame TSU, because at the end of the day, every college and every university goes through these things. Like, every university has financial aid issues. So you're really going to experience this at majority of your colleges. This is how you deal with it and how you process it and everything like that. That's going to determine your outcome. That's going to determine if you're, you know, going to still be able to go to TSU. Because if you're not able to handle these small issues, then you're just not going to make it. As far as like being an on-campus student, there's going to be things about housing that you're just not going to like, and you're honestly just going to have to suck it up, really. Of course, there are some things that, you know, it's just not tolerable, I guess you could say, such as, like, let's for example, insects or things of that sort. Of course, if something like that pops up in your dorm, you're going to want to take that to a higher up and address those issues. But there's going to be things such as like the heat in the air. They cut the heat on at a specific, they cut the air off at a specific time in the season, and they turn the heat on. So like, it's going to be maybe a week and a half where you're not going to have heat, just for the simple fact that they have to turn it on, and they wait until it gets cold all throughout the day and all throughout the night to cut the heat on. If that makes sense. You may have issues with financial aid. If you haven't already, go click on the video, the call it, did I make the wrong college decision video? That is a video that I made my freshman year. It was around the time that I was dealing with TSU and the financial aid department, and I had a lot of things to say about the financial aid department, because I felt like they didn't really care about my issues and things that I needed to, you know, get taken care of. And I feel like that's your job. Like, your job working in that office is to literally come to work and make sure students get their financial aid and go home. Yes, there's things added on to that, but at the end of the day, if I come to you like, hey, my account says that I owe thousands of dollars, why do I owe thousands of dollars when I'm an in-state student? Like, can you let me? And I'm a freshman at the time, y'all, so I'm not knowing how all of this financial aid stuff worked for real. So I had a lot of questions and concerns, because I'm like, I don't just have no $4,000 to just be like, oh, here you go. Like, no, they had very nasty attitudes, and I don't want to say all of them, but I don't remember the specific names, but some of the people in the office did have very bad attitudes towards students, and it was just a mess. Now, on the flip side, students had attitudes with people in the financial aid department. So with students coming up to them with their attitudes, it's only going to make them have a negative attitude back. So I do say, or I will say, that if you are having any issues with anything, you need to approach that situation like an adult. As as the adult that you are, like, don't go in no office clowning and doing extra stuff. Don't do that, because it's not gonna get anything solved. So if you do just have those issues, handle it wisely. Okay, now moving on, let's say the calf, let me say that they do be having some good food. I ain't even gonna lie. They do have good food. They always have different different meals set out for you. Now, it's not like that every day. Some days you may go in there and only see pizza and some fries, or you may go in there and see a full home cooked meal or whatever. It just really depends on the days. Like, they have fried chicken Wednesday, they have themes throughout homecoming week. So yeah, you're not really gonna have any issues with the calf, besides the fact that it's 9 times out of 10 is gonna be dirty unless they've changed it. But there's always gonna be some on the tables. The floors are always gonna be dirty. This sounds so bad. Sometimes the drink machines be out and they'll only have like one or two different types of sodas available. So like, yeah, it just be like ghetto stuff like that. You just be like, why? Now, why can I only get pink lemonade and Mountain Dew? Now, come on now. Why can't I get no ice? No ice in the machine. Ice cream machine may not be working. So it's just like, it just be stuff that I feel like people don't have the urgency to take care of, which is why you have like little problems like that. But other than that, your experience, I mean this from the bottom of my heart, your experience is the way you make it. If you choose to come into TSU, not get involved, complain about everything, don't get the most out of your experience, then you're gonna have a bad experience. Now if you come and you realize that, yeah, TSU may be lacking on some stuff, but at the end of the day, I'll make the most out of this situation. Like, yeah, the heat may not be on for another week or two, but I'm here and I have a job to do while I'm here, which is to get my degree. So yeah, that's basically all that I have to say. On a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the best experience in the world and 1 being the worst, I would say I've had anywhere between a 7 and an 8. And I'm only a sophomore, so I haven't experienced everything that there is to experience. But you're going to meet a lot of different people at TSU. You're going to experience a lot of things that's going to test your character, and that's going to and I honestly, to me, I just feel like they're tests from God. Like, he is sculpting you to be this wonderful adult human being. So of course he's going to throw stuff at you left and right. You're going to have so many stressful things come up when you go to college. Like, and I'm just being, well, for me, I'm speaking for me. For me, it's just been like, you're going to have a lot of things that just come up out of nowhere, that it's going to be a lot of stress factors when you come to college. It's just going to be a lot that is going to be on your plate, and you have to learn how to eat this portion and then eat this portion and then eat this portion until you've made a happy plate or whatever. Yeah, that is just, oh my god, I'm crazy. But yeah, so that's basically how I feel about being a student at TSU. It's always something to do. I know I'm a part of Phi Sigma and Honor Society, which is a society that you have the possible chance of joining if you do good your freshman year and you make good grades, make that dean's list or that president's list, have a high GPA, and guess what? You're gonna get that email saying, hello, my name is such and such from Phi Eta Sigma, and I'm inviting you to join the blah blah blah. You can do that if you want to. But if you come up here and you want to go party every other weekend or every weekend, and you want to show up late to class, and you want to not show up to class, and you want to copy other people's notes, and you want to, what else these students be doing? Get smart with the teacher, and you want to not turn in your work, and not submit stuff to the dropouts on time, and all that other stuff that falls up under the category of being a bad student, then you are not going to make it at TSU. Okay, y'all, I'm really done. I'm done. Like, I'm done for real. Thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you like this video. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Subscribe. And if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, just let me know in the comments below. Oh, you know how we go. Oh, okay, guys. Thank you so much. Yeah,